finally pure of heart, Delphina.
Yes, your soul shines down on us like the reflection of sunlight on a recently washed butter knife.
And as I felt the bonds between me and my earthly form shatter, I was able to take solace in the fact that my family could no longer defend themselves against the invading sea poets.
Hey, Jamie.
What's up?
Jamie!
Damn it! I turned that movie on so that I could fall asleep. Does anybody care that I was up all night editing a very merry stock photo Christmas?
I appreciate that, I really do, but we gotta go do this, okay? Gone squanching. Alright, everybody listen up. I just spoke to the building super, alright, and he said our quarterly tornado drill is today. Just a regular thing, so we'll just get this done and get back to work, okay?
Wait, what's going on?
It's just a regularly scheduled fire drill. I mean, tornado.
Fire drill? Screw it. I'm gonna go sleep in my truck. Oh, yeah, guys, we got evicted, by the way. I thought you'd want to know.
What?
See ya.
And that is the true meaning of Christmas, George Bernard Shaw.
Thanks, Santa Claus. By the way, nice beard.
You too, Georgie.
Oh my God, I don't believe it.
What?
It took like a year, but Dryck Apelsin finally responded to my email.
The Dryck Apelsin?
Who's Dryck
Apelsin? What does she mean, who's Dryck Apelsin? Unbelievable.
He's a famous art film director.
He directed an ode to Paul Giamatti.
Not to mention Fading Whispers of the Hill People.
Yeah, and Hearing with My Eyes.
Are these even real movies?
He's agreed to come make some short films for the channel. We're gonna have a meeting with him later today to go over ideas.
Oh, this is it! This could be the thing that saves the channel! Does he have any specific ideas for later today?
No. He likes to come up with them on the spot, makes it feel more organic. It's his process!
What a genius.
That's not the word I would use.
Did you get my email?
What email?
What do you mean, what email?
What was this?
I don't believe in doors.
Right, well, let's get this meeting started, shall we?
This guy must be great at parties.
Shh, quiet. He's a genius.
Okay, so it's the week before Christmas, and the Taliban...
Sorry, but no.
Okay, fine, so it's Christmas time, and Lee Harvey Oswald...
Nope.
Alright. So, it's around Christmas, and Adolf Hitler...
No!
Right, I forgot. Christmas is a touchy subject for you guys. Now, everyone thinks that Adolf Hitler committed suicide after World War II, yes?
Because he did?
But what if he didn't? Okay, just hear me out on this. Let's pretend that after World War II, Adolf Hitler moved to Florida, got hired at SeaWorld, and used his powers of persuasion to climb the corporate ladder and bend the dolphins to his will. I call it a dolphin tale. Okay, you know what? Fine. Since you guys don't seem to like any of my original ideas, how about we just do a remake of The Room instead?
The Brie Larson movie? That came out like a year or two ago.
No, the Tommy Wiseau film. You know, the good one.
Please stop.
Okay, you know what? Fine. Those were just my lowest common denominator ideas. Something to appeal to the masses. But if you want something that will truly enrapture your audiences, something that will be acclaimed by critics and fans everywhere, something that will bring a whole new level of fame and prominence to the Family Learning Channel, just listen to my next idea. It'll knock your socks off.
All right, one idea.
All right, so just hear me out on this, right? A woman is convicted of a crime, but here's the catch. She didn't commit it. Her twin sister did. So now she has to set out to find her twin sister and prove her innocence so that she doesn't get the death penalty. It's called Twinnocence.
It's a start.
Thanks. Clearly you weren't as stupid as I first thought.
I would hope not.
Welcome.
Corey, right?
You seriously don't remember my name. We dated for 2 years, Drake.
Well, I'm sure I'd remember someone as beautiful as you, Charlene.
Unbelievable. This is the exact sort of thing that you would do.
You know, Mr. Apelsin, I'm sure it must get pretty lonely being a big-time movie director and all. I know you must have to keep some pretty big cinematic secrets, and if there's any way I could help take a load off of you, that I would do that.
Look, Tomas, is it? I don't share anything from my pictures with anyone, okay? So you'll just have to wait until it's in theaters, just like everyone else.
But I'm your boss.
Well, Frank hired me.
I'm Frank's boss.
Are you really, though?
I'll do anything.
I'm sorry, Tomas, but I just don't show sneak peeks to anyone. Unless, of course, you could perhaps give me some coffee.
Done.
Meant from the coffee maker in the kitchen, but okay.
You know, Frank, a big shot director like Dryck doesn't come cheap.
I know, I've been trying to think of a way that we can come up with the money to pay him. The budget is stretched so tight as it is. Hopefully the money from his films will generate enough profits, but we don't have any money to pay him to begin with. It's a catch-22. Anything we can do to make money costs money.
Not necessarily. I mean, we've got a lot of reruns stockpiled. Maybe if we slowly play more and more reruns, people won't notice that we have less new content.
All right, it's a start. I'm gonna go to the bathhouse for a few hours. Alex is working on a project, but I need you to keep an eye on Dryck, okay?
Actually, about that, Dryck and I are...
It's gonna be great. You're gonna be great.
Thomas? Hey, Jamie, have you seen Thomas?
I think he left to go get coffee.
In the middle of a work day? Why?
Beats me.
I brought you your coffee, Mr. Apelsin.
I didn't ask you for any of that American swill. Shame on you for leaving work like that and to blame it on me to boot.
Whatever. Thomas, just please show Drake around the studio.
And will you not be accompanying us, Miss Cambridge?
No, I won't, Rodney.
So, how come you lied and said you didn't want the coffee?
Thomas, have you ever been in love? It's like your entire life, your left sock just
floating through the washing machine of life until one day you finally meet the perfect matching right sock to complete your pair, and everything seems fine and dandy until one day your right sock leaves you for an ascot, and suddenly you're left alone, tumbling through the washing machine of life all alone, and you've got a hole in your seam, and it's ripping, it's getting bigger and bigger, and you're drowning under the water of the washing machine. You're trying to gasp for air, but you can't breathe because you're a sock and you don't have internal organs!
I think I get it. You just like a really specific kind of coffee.
I'll do better next time.
Yes, you should, Thomas, because that coffee was garbage. But that isn't the point.
You know, I envy you. Getting to work on creative stuff while I'm stuck behind the desk all day. It's a good thing those Girl Scouts showed up when they did. Anyway, here's the studio. This is probably where you're gonna be doing most of your work, so we won't be able to hang out that much. Which is okay, because people need their space, and yeah, this is the studio. Over here is the soundboard, which we use to control all of.
Got it from here. Thomas, if you want to be useful, why don't you just go, I don't know, buy a mattress or something. I'm going to be working a lot of late nights. Thanks.
Thanks.
Hey! Sorry I was late. We just hired Dryck Apelsin to make some films for the station, and he's an interesting guy. I just had to stop on the way over and check on some licensing rights.
Frank, let me stop you right there. Do you know why I bought this tower?
I have a few guesses.
Maybe it would be easier to tell you why I didn't buy this tower. I did not buy this tower so that the world could be privileged with more Pasta Camp reruns. I did not buy this tower to listen to excuses from one of my many subordinates. And I did not buy this tower so that Dryck Apelsin's ego could get in the way. Even if I do find his films intellectually stimulating, I bought this tower so that we could broadcast my message as agreed upon.
Yeah, I know.
Well then why aren't you doing it, Franklin?
Actually, my name isn't short for—
Shut up, Franklin. Did you know that I gave you this station a year ago today? 1 year. Did you know that?
Hey, time flies when you're having fun, right?
But what do I have to show for it, Frank? Nothing. I'm not asking for much. It was supposed to start out small. A little sign here, a little subliminal messaging there, and then the big stuff would come after a while. But I'm starting to think that you were never really planning to get around to it at all.
No, I was. I am, I swear. I swear. I got so enamored with the idea of owning the station, actually creating something. It just, I couldn't jeopardize that.
Oh, spare me. Your time is running out, Frank. And you don't want to let me down, because I will crush you. Gentlemen, please escort Mr. Holloway out of the building.
Look, I told you like 3 weeks ago, stop saying stuff like that.
Shut up, you breakfast food bitch!
Betty!
Cheese grater saying mean things about my sister.
Shut up, Tic Tac!
Why?
What do you keep calling me cheese grater for? What's up with that?
Hey, Tic Tac, go clean your room.
This is what I have to deal with. Cheese grater, would you please escort Mr. Holloway out of the building? Consider this your final warning, Frank. My patience is running very thin.
I love your enthusiasm. Thomas, what are you doing here?
I work here.
Why were you trying to wake me up?
I just wanted to tell you that it's time to go home for the day.
At 3:30 in the afternoon?
Sure.
You Americans always were a lazy bunch, even when we had you colonized.
I'll walk you out.
Not right now,
Courtney. I'm walking Mr. Apelsin to his car. That's not how it's pronounced. Thomas, did you remember to buy that mattress I asked for?
Oh. Knew I forgot something. Hey, Are you still gonna show me those sneak peeks we were talking about earlier?
No, Thomas. Sneak peeks are for boys who remember to buy mattresses.
I'll be right back.
Thomas! Thomas! What the hell, Drake? You're supposed to be helping the channel, not running it into the ground.
Look, my lackey is
Thomas is not your lackey. He's the manager.
Sir, can I get you anything else?
I'm fine, Thomas. Courtney, do you want anything?
Yeah, for Thomas to get back to work.
Courtney says she's fine, Thomas. Anyway, you were saying he isn't my lackey?
Just get back to work.
I will if you will. You know, this is just like that one time in college when we went to the Mexican restaurant.
Oh, and you couldn't remember my name up until an hour ago, but you remember that!
Did you ever consider that maybe I didn't want to remember because you'd hurt me too badly? Did you ever think of that, Courtney? No, you didn't, because all you're concerned about is the stupid channel.
Your accent is wildly inconsistent!
Director, writer, actor, producer, executive producer, editor, cinematographer, part-time caterer, sock puppet enthusiast, visionary, and so much more. The mastermind behind such acclaimed films as Angry Angus, The Pool of Water, The Pool of Water 2, A Pool of Blood is thicker than A Pool of Water, and Sir is coming to the Family Learning Channel this winter.
Well, that's the best we could do with the limited footage available.
He said most of it was too pure to be tainted by a flat-screen TV. Evidently, he's just slumming it just by being here. Don't you think it just seems a bit egotistical?
Condescending.
Douchey.
Yes, yes, and yeah, just start airing it with those episodes of You and Your Flan.
Franklin.
Why does everyone assume my name is short? Never mind. What is it?
I need you to schedule a premiere for The Twinnessence tonight.
What? Why?
Well, generally, you see, when a movie is done being made...
Yeah, no, I get that, but how's the movie already done being made? You haven't even let us into the studio yet.
That's not true. Come in.
I have your sustenance, sir. Chicken wings.
Thank you, Thomas. You know, I only go to Hooters for the wings.
Well said, sir.
How do you expect me to schedule a premiere tonight? We're already all booked up.
Actually, Frank, tonight we're gonna be running reruns of a very pasta prequel.
Okay, fine. I'll try and squeeze it in.
That's what I thought.
Hey, Mr. Apelsin. Maybe tonight you should come to the office, watch the premiere with us. Yeah, it'd be great. You could bring the cast.
I don't see a problem with that. It's good to spend some time with the little people. It helps me to write more grounded characters.
Team bonding.
I'll be right back, you guys.
Okay.
Hey, Thomas, can I talk to Drake alone?
No! We don't want your kind here.
What kind? Women?
No. Squares.
Go away, Thomas.
Fine. I'll go.
Can we talk for a minute? Okay. Look, about the other day, I'm sorry I overstepped my boundaries.
No, you're right. I should be contributing to the channel in a more positive manner, I suppose.
Yeah, but it's just really surprising to see you here after not seeing you for so long. I mean, and then you didn't remember me, and that just threw me for a loop, I guess. I never really stopped to consider how things ended.
It's just that, you know, you were my first muse, and you inspired me in my passion for art and for creativity. And when we made films together, they weren't just films. They were vessels of light from the gods. And I don't think I can ever truly match what I created with you. I'm just a shell of my former self now, and I'm worried that everyone will see me for the true fraud that I am. Dryck Apelsin, with an emphasis on the sin. And I just, now that you're here, and you're, Courtney, my scars! You did this to me!
Craig. Craig, I'm so sorry. Rodney. You know, maybe it's not too late to... I don't know, maybe...
And that is the kind of acting that I am looking for as a director, Courtney. Really had you going there, didn't I? Yeah.
You jerk! You know, I was actually starting to trust you again.
I know. Saw right through you. You never were a very good actress. And that is why I dumped you.
I dumped you!
I can't believe my twin sister is gone.
Wow, she is really good. I even think I recognize her from something.
Oh no, Catherine's not famous. I found her sitting in my favorite booth at IHOP. And in order to persuade her to leave, I promised I'd let her star in my next picture.
Well, she's very good, very convincing.
Derek had met my sister when we were filming the movie, and now he doesn't remember which mansion he left her in.
I gotta go take this.
I can't get a break.
Hey, Beta, buddy, what's going on?
Big premiere tonight. Did you find a chance to sneak in a message from your sponsor?
Well, Dryck is really anti-product placement, so...
Frank, quit stalling. You know what I mean.
Relax, I got to sneak in some new signals into the new commercial rolling out this afternoon.
I didn't see anything.
Well, must be pretty good subliminal messaging then, right?
Frank, I swear, if you're trying...
Oh, Betty, I gotta go.
Take that message! Hey!
Frank's balls are delicious, and I will take that comment accordingly!
Hey, what's going on?
I found this old video of Dryck's, and I thought it would be funny to show it to them. I didn't know Courtney was in it, and then, well, one thing led to another.
Dryck, what did you say before I came in? Dryck, that's gross. As soon as I get back, you're out of here. I don't even understand why people like your garbage.
What the?
You know you don't have to work in the literal smallest never mind. This is actually good that I ran into you. I'm sure you're getting plenty of complaints with all this stuff. What do you mean, no? This is just a smiley face with an up arrow. So you haven't got a single complaint. Not one. So people actually like this stuff. You're useless.
Your move, Franklin.
I'm sorry, but the station...
Yeah, I understand.
See, I told you these reruns would be profitable.
Plus, you really do notice new things each time you watch these runs.
Yeah?
I think Dryck's taking it a bit far, even by his own standards. Check out this clip from his new movie.
So that's the one he's been filming.
This is the one that aired last night.
What? How did he make another one that quickly?
Apparently he filmed them back to back.
How did he slip it past me to get on air? It must have been Thomas, that idiot. Alright, Jamie, we're gonna go down to the studio, okay? And Alex, you stay here and make sure Dryck doesn't pull anything else, okay? Let's get out of here.
I guess it must be pretty hard working around the clock.
Ha 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 ha, good one. Look.
Hey, guys! What's up? Long time no see.
Well, yeah, it's been kind of hard to see you, seeing as you've been here all the time.
You know, it said in my job description that I would help run the day-to-day operations of this station.
Wasting my life in a coloring book, destined to draw in blue, but thinking in red.
Kelly, what are you doing here?
Well, I accidentally read a newspaper this morning, and I saw the casting call for Rain Seeds. When I saw the Family Learning Channel was producing, I knew I had to come to work with you.
Well, where's Bert?
He was gonna come, but he's not feeling well.
I'm so confused.
That's because you wouldn't know good art if it hit you in your pleasant Aryan face.
What?
This is Rain Seeds. The story of Father Time, who in our version is female because it is 2017 after all. It also features myself as the Sun King, and I descend from the heavens and use my lightning powers to defeat the Hellspawn Frank for Holiday. There's also a live opera score by famed pianist Alfonso Fliedermann, but I suppose you don't know who that is either.
Okay, I just came down to address the fact that you aired an entire movie last night without seeking my approval first. I'm the head of the channel. You're a creative. You gotta run these things by me, so what's going on here?
I have absolutely no idea what you're talking about, you cheeky monkey.
Don't play that game with me. Oh great, the other pain in my ass. You're in charge. I gotta go take care of something.
Thomas, do you know what he's talking about?
Well, Dryck, you did air an entire movie without his approval last night. He's probably talking about that.
Do I look like Dryck to you?
Well, since you are him, then yeah.
What on earth are you prattling on about, Thomas? I am the Sun King. Where is that Applestein? He's supposed to be running this Mickey Mouse operation.
Sir, I'm trying to tell you.
Just find him. Or you know what? Fire him. I don't care. You're the manager around here.
Why would you want me to fire?
Just fire Dryck, you idiot.
Okay.
Done?
You're fired.
Why do you keep telling me that I'm Dryck? Thomas, it can't be. I didn't want to fire myself. I may be the Sun King, but I proclaim you the Sun Emperor. Thomas, please don't do this.
I'm sorry, Mr. Appleton. There's nothing I can do for you.
Thomas, please, fix this. You're the boss around here.
I am fixing it by firing you.
Fine, Thomas. I know when I've been beat, but I swear you have not seen the last of Dryck Apelsin. Actually, you haven't. I need to grab my hat. You still haven't seen the last of me. Rain Seeds 2018.
Oh man, I gotta tell Frank. Frank. Yeah.
Sorry. You can go home. No more Rain Seeds for today.
Her parents named me Q-Rex because of my really sharp teeth.
You must be pretty happy, huh? I can't imagine it was very fun for you to have to work with him. I'd be ecstatic if I were you. But you don't seem pretty happy.
Don't get me wrong, I'm glad Drake's gone, but... I mean, he did nothing but decrease productivity and be rude to me. It is... It's just weird seeing him and thinking about who he used to be. I mean, working with Rodney was the reason I decided to get into this business at all. Without him, I wouldn't have even met any of you guys, so... In a sense, I guess I'll miss him.
His name was Rodney?
Okay, look who's talking, Alexis.
Okay, fair enough. But you're sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Come on, let's go help Jamie with the pies.
Hey, Frank. Dryck is gone.
Yeah, I know. Thanks for stepping up.
It was about time.
Listen, Thomas, I got a lot of work to get done, so if you don't mind...
You're an idiot, Frank.
What?
It's a simple question. Do you think I'm an idiot?
No, Thomas. There was a reason we hired you in the first place.
Yeah. I was the only one who applied.
Okay. Maybe that was part of it. But you know, Thomas, you still have your job. And yeah, you're a little out there, but you're good at your job. I mean, your interview was weird. It was really weird. But you have ideas, and that's something. And you know what? You really saved us with that stand-up special. I mean that. You saved our asses.
Before that, though... You were thinking of firing me.
Yeah, I had some doubts about you, but you know, this is my first leadership role. I have to look out for everyone. I have to, you know, make sure the team makes it. I have to cut the fat. And I thought, for a time, that you were fat. But you're not, Thomas. You're like the good part of the meat. You're like the nice, I don't eat a lot of steak, I can't afford it.
Don't be so melodramatic. There are only 6 people working there anyway.
Well, it's a bit more complicated than that.
Enlighten me.
Well, I acquired the station from a government black ops agent who could kill us or throw us in jail at any time if we don't transmit her secret, like, subliminal messages, and if we don't do exactly what she says, we're all screwed, and you know, I'm in way over my head, and they're coming down on me, and, so, yeah, that.
Well,